Stone Thailand Major for Southeast Asia. My name is TJ, and I'm joined by the only guy I know who's named after a famous YouTube cat. It's Mara.
Crab.
Mara, on a scale of 1 to 7, how excited are you for this match?
Pretty good. I mean, pretty excited. Just
scale of 1 to 7.
1 to 7.
Oof.
Cat.
Yeah. Cat. So Maru. That's so Maru. Why don't you go jump into a box and slide across the floor? No, but next match coming up is Shy versus Jackpot. Mm-hmm. Both these players have some interesting deck lists.
Yeah.
Jackpot's made it this far without Shaman in his list.
And that's very commendable.
It is. Mm-hmm. Just want to go give him a high five for not having Shaman in his list. But yeah, should be a good matchup. There's a schedule for today. We're now going to move into the round of four upper brackets. So the winner's bracket semifinals, which means both of these players have guaranteed themselves a top eight finish, so they're in the money. Mm-hmm. And if they win this match, they guarantee top three. So third would be the lowest that they could finish. It's pretty darn good.
Yeah, especially for Jackpot, who apparently is his first ever tournament. Mm-hmm. He's a local Thai guy. And works as an engineer. He found Hearthstone on the app store, randomly stumbled across it, and then once he started playing, he found out that esports existed.
Yeah.
How? Almost like an Aladdin-esque rags-to-riches story here.
Yes, it is. Maybe he'll get a magic carpet ride as well. But yeah, there's their deck list. Bans are in. So Shy went ahead and banned away the warrior from Jackpot. That was a dragon warrior. I actually saw Jackpot play on stream yesterday against the one Jack. That was the last match on the stream yesterday. And Jackpot went ahead and banned away Shy's mid-range shaman. So definitely a powerful deck and doesn't want to face against that. Both players have hunters. Both players have druids. The one difference being is Shy has rogue and Jackpot has the tempo mage.
I'm a big fan of tempo mage, actually. It's super fun to play. Flame Waker pings, there's just something exciting about them.
Yeah. He's got the Babbling Books as well as a Cabal's Tome.
Yeah.
So it becomes even more exciting.
Two Fireland Portals as well.
Two Fireland Portals. Yep. So it's a little bit of an interesting build. We saw it yesterday against the one Jack, and it was a Temple Mage Mirror. And it was really insane. I'm pretty sure there was like six Cabal's Tome played in one game. Because Cabal's Tome gave Cabal's Tome, Babbling Books were giving Cabal's Tome. Each player had like a full hand for like the whole game. And then they just unloaded their hand and played Yogg-Saroth.
You know Leonardo DiCaprio somewhere just saying like, we must go deeper.
Yeah. We need more Cabal's
Tome. Yeah.
But yeah, let us know what you guys are thinking of the matches today. You can tweet at HearthSEA, or you can talk to one of us on Twitter. And you make sure you use the hashtag HearthSEAMajor. Let us know what you think of the matches. Let us know who you're rooting for, what country you're from, and where you're watching from. There's still a wide variety of players left in the tournament. Mm-hmm. We have players from Singapore, players from Malaysia, like we just saw Chonger win. Lots of Thai players still left in the tournament. And so just let us know. And it's going to be a fun day moving forward. At the end of the day, we are going to crown another Southeast Asia major champion.
Yeah, it's so great to see more of these bigger tournaments come to the, you know, lesser represented regions. Just for the viewers also to find out what is happening in these regions at all.
Asia Pacific is kind of the sleeper region a lot of times. Europe and the Americas dominated Hearthstone for a long time because it felt like they were given more attention with major tournaments and things like that. You know, discounting the first world champion, which was Artosis.
Right.
We can say the first world champion was Fireman, the second world champion was Osaka, so we got America's Europe. Maybe it's time for an Asia-Pacific champion, and more specifically, maybe it's time for a Southeast Asian champion.
That would be really cool. Yeah. Actually, I wanted to ask you something. The first night, we were actually...
It's
a bit of a...
Long story?
Yeah.
Okay, in between
we'll
the next
game. We'll save it
for... Yeah. Give you guys something to look forward to, and me as well, because I was really curious. But yeah, first game of the match is going to be Temple Mage for Jackpot versus the Token Druid from Shy. You can see he's got Ancient of War. He's also got double Moonglade portals in this deck. Other than that, though, pretty standard Token Druid.
Mm-hmm. This could be another Yogg face-off here.
Could be. We've actually seen a lot of those.
Yeah.
About the weekend. It seems like I want to see how players would react when if Yogg wasn't in the game.
Because
I'm pretty sure the decks that would run Yogg would still be good. It would just force people to play a little bit differently.
Yeah.
You can't go all in with your spells early. You also can't be a little bit greedy. Yeah. Knowing that you have Yogg as like a win condition later on.
Yeah, especially with the newer Druid decks where they're running the Malygos, you know, throwing in Gadgets and Oxygen Air.
Doesn't really need Yogg. Yogg's just there for those games where you lose if Yogg did do something crazy. So
Innervate.
Oh yeah. That's really good.
Looking like a pretty slow start though for both players. That Innervate might speed things up to pretty quickly here.
It's hard to think who benefits the most from a slow game. Because Jackpot doesn't really have to do anything. I mean, he can just keep playing it slow as long as Shy's not ramping.
Yeah.
He can just draw cards and wait to use his spells reactively.
Yeah.
But Shy also just has big minions that are really hard to deal with. So if he gets an Ancient of Four down and Jackpot doesn't have the spell power and spells to deal with it, I don't know. It's hard to say who's going to come out on top in a long game.
Yeah, people seem to be building these tempo mages a bit more focused on the higher side of the curve these days. Like, in the ANZ region, you've got a lot of guys just going full aggro with it.
Yeah.
It's almost like a hybrid where you're playing for tempo, but if you see the weakness, you just go for it. You start, you know, hitting those spells to the face.
Here, though, this weekend, it seems like a lot of these players are playing tempo mage for more of a slow game.
Yeah, for sure.
Their lists are a little bit more minion-heavy and run Kabbalah's Tomes, a little bit more of the top end. Sometimes they cut some of the one drops. Like, I think Jackpot might have cut, like, one mirror image and I think one other one shot, but I can't remember exactly what it was, in favor of playing a water elemental. He also cut a torch. That's what he cut.
Right.
So it's a little bit of an interesting list, but I mean, it's done work for him so far. Being in the winner bracket semifinals is definitely means he's doing something right.
I feel like Jackpot just really hates Shaman, so he has like a water elemental to try and freeze Phage face, and it could be good against, you know, the Warriors as well.
Yeah, he banned Shaman, so he's like, water elemental is fantastic against Warrior, because it's really hard for them to kill. They have to invest a lot of resources in it, and if you think most of the players are going to bring Dragon War, you basically shut off weapons for most of the game.
Mm-hmm.
It also lines up really nicely because of the fact that it trades well into a lot of the minions that Dragon Warrior plays, like Corcoran Elite, Alexander's Champion, even Twilight Guardian, attacking into it, shutting off its attack, and dealing with it with a spell the next turn.
Yeah.
Is actually really good.
Job's done.
And there comes that Innervate into Ancient War, turn 5.
Yeah.
It's going to require a lot of spells here to really break through that 10 body.
Well, it's a good thing Jackpot's got a lot of spells.
Right.
I don't even know if it's worth it, though, yet.
Yeah, he can probably afford to take 5.
Yeah. But he has to develop something. So maybe just like Water Elemental and Seiko. Because the only way he'd be able to kill it, he has to like Flame Waker, Arcane Blast, Arcane Blast, Arcane Missiles.
Mm.
And then you'd get 9 total missiles. And 6 of them would have to hit the Ancient of War. Actually, no, you'd get 11 total missiles because you'd have to coin.
Oh, okay.
6 of them would have to hit the Ancient of War. That's a lot of resources.
50. Yeah. Especially when, you know, your opponent has the potential to kind of flood the board with low health tokens and stuff. You just kind of want to save those pings for those kind of situations. But it's like I go over
Frostbolt.
Okay.
Okay. This is sort of the halfway point where you're just like sort of holding on to it to deal with it the following turn and hope that your opponent doesn't have a way to kill your Flame Waker. But Shy does. He's got the swipe. And the wrath.
Yeah, whenever I'm facing a tempo mage, I'm always just saving my spells that have 4 damage just for specifically for that Flame Waker. Sometimes I end up using it on an Azure Drake, but... Okay. He doesn't want to let the Mono Worm grow at all.
Nope. Really smart play. He's rolling it to Ancient of War, so he realizes that all he needs to do is just keep this one healthy, force Jackpot into a situation where he has to use more resources in order to remove. Right now, if Jackpot wants to get rid of it, he's got a Forgotten Torch, Arcane Blast, Ping, and then he's not developing anything. And then Shy just slams another Ancient of War and says, deal with this. Mm.
Jackpot draws that Babbling Book. Kind of looks like a taco as well. Babbling Taco.
It'd be a great card.
Yeah. Sounds delicious.
Oh, Taco put a random taco in your hand. The tacos would be like the toxins.
Yeah.
From... Zero poison mine.
Hmm.
The 2 damage taco would be
get food poisoning. Take 2 damage.
Spicy taco.
Burns mouth.
You want to cast the spell?
The return, the taco to your hand would be tofu taco because nobody would want to eat it.
Tastes so bad.
So you return it back into your hand. Is that what you try and get a new taco? Remember that one taco?
This taco doesn't taste good. I want to exchange it.
Yeah.
I don't think it works that way. But
the three attack taco would be like. What tacos give you the most energy?
It's like a really sharp, hard shell taco.
Yeah, there you go. Makes you angry. What's the last toxin?
Draw a card.
The last taco you get is a 2-for-1 taco.
The coupon.
You're welcome, Blizzard.
Yeah, we're just designing cards all day here.
Well, these Babylon books are actually pretty good. Icebox buys you a whole extra turn later on in the game. If that's going to be a turn where, you know, you can kill your opponent the following turn, Polymorph's just a fantastic way to deal with an Ancient of War, knowing that there's not really any other big threats in the deck aside from whatever Shy could get from Moonglade Portal.
Yeah. Man, Babbling Books and stuff where you discover the cards, it makes it so hard for your opponent because they have no idea what those cards could be. And so it's impossible to play around. So you just kind of... You just kind of have to hope they don't have a Polymorph when you throw in that Ancient of War in there.
Yep. So we're going to go ahead and trade in. Not too shabby. And Jackpot still has a lot of resources left, even though like a lot of his stuff is very situational. You still got stuff to do. All right, let's see what you get from the Moonglade Portal. Wobbling Runts!
Oh, okay. If that dies.
Alright, what are the three runs names?
I don't know, I'm sorry. Do you know?
No. I thought I did. I actually thought I did. Because I just cast a tournament last week where we didn't know what the runs were called. We looked it up after.
Yeah.
And I was like, I'm never going to forget these.
Oh.
A week later, I've already forgotten them.
Right.
I don't even know. I don't remember one.
That's like me for every high school exam. I'm never going to forget this. Yeah. Next day. Ooh.
Yep.
I think I've seen that card once in Arena. Okay, I think that's it.
Actually just remembered.
Oh, you did?
What the run names are, yeah. It's a rascally one, runt, a wily runt, and a grumbly runt.
This is why you're top caster, man. That memory.
That memory. Super legit.
It's like a hard drive. You can just seek through it.
Very slow processor, though. takes a few minutes.
Need to get some solid state drives in there.
Yeah. Well, Jackpot can just keep buying more time. Kona Cold. But eventually he's going to have to deal with those runs. And a Firelands Portal. That's really good.
That's not good.
Not really good.
Is that the lowest possible stat line you can get out of a
Starving
drop?
Buzzard.
Oh, yeah. 3-2.
Ram Wrangler's tied. Grim Patron is tied. But Grim Patron has the bonus effect.
Mm-hmm.
Big Game Hunter, arguably.
Yeah.
Could be worse than the 3-3s.
It's easier to remove. But
because, easier to remove, but it has a higher stat line.
Ooh. Mm-hmm.
Temple Enforcer is just pretty good.
Yeah.
Vanilla stats. Of course, Boulder Fist Ogre is better.
Mm-hmm.
But Temple Enforcer is up there as far as good six drops that you can get.
Now, suddenly, Shy has a very nice board advantage here, but is lacking resources in his hand.
Yeah. Can buy some time, though.
Yeah. Let's make magic.
A 6-damage Arcane Blast is absurd. And just going to try and protect these spell power minions. Going to try and clear off as much stuff as possible. Clears off 2-1-1s. That's not bad.
Yep. And this is why I love Mirror Image. You can just put that in between your minions and your opponents, and they have to deal with it to get through. This is a good way, though. I'm ready to learn.
That's a pretty scary board.
Yeah. Could it be time?
For the Yogg-Saron. He's played a lot of spells, actually.
Yeah.
Because he's played most of the spells from his early hand plus Cabal's Tome. He's put a lot of one drops. Arcane Missiles, 2 Arcane Blasts so far this game.
Yeah.
He might be able to wait and buy a little bit more time.
It's so scary, though, leaving two Violet Teachers on the board.
Yeah, he can, like, clear one and then Kona Cold.
Okay, yeah.
And start trying to ping down one of the Violet Teachers.
Right.
He could also just Azure Drake and kill one with the Fireball. Mm-hmm. Try and see if he can pick up, like, or maybe even picks up... No, he's used both Arcane Blast. Not sure. So I'm trying to think what's the best option here.
I like the Fireball, Kona Cold. Just grow your Yogg, buy some time.
Yeah.
I mean, your opponent is just kind of drawing one card at a time to add to this board, or... So I think... Despite the board state, he does have a little bit of time here.
Fireball the one in the middle. Kona Cold the far left. Oh, he's actually going to go with... Yeah, Kona Cold, I guess, doesn't really serve too much of a purpose here. It's going to take, like, 5 power immediately off the board.
Mm-hmm.
But he still gets the benefit from the Violet Teacher. So...
Yeah. But the life clock is ticking. It's down to 13 health.
Yes. That Wobbling Rose has gotten in some damage.
Yeah, it's... You just don't want to kill it, because, you know, 3 more runs pop out, and then... But at the same time, since it's been buffed, it's been swinging for 3 every time.
Yeah. Who wants maximum Yogg potential, then Kona Cold, Arcane Missiles, and probably Arcane Missiles first. Because those 2-1-1s being in the middle make it a little bit awkward. But if he doesn't want that, I would like Blood Mage plus Arcane Missiles, because then you might be able to get into a situation where you can ping down the Violet Teacher, because that's a lot of missiles. I mean, 5, yeah. I guess. It's not really that many. You'd have to hit 4.
Okay.
I think that's an...
Oh!
I think that's an error. I think you should Arcane Missile first. I don't know.
But I mean, he could have...
If he Arcane Missiles first, then as long as he clears off 1-1-1, he also freezes the Wobbling Runs. So
yeah.
He blocks more damage.
True.
Now the Wobbling Runs is getting in damage again. He probably would have had less of a chance to kill off a Violet Teacher, but you can't bank on 3 of those missiles hitting the Violet Teacher out of 4.
Yeah,
so.
Well, I mean, apparently you can.
Apparently you can. But now it's got to be Yogg. And... You know, the ice block doesn't really matter on your turn, so he could still kill himself, even though he has ice block available.
That Cult Apothecary could come in handy later, though, if his if the runs are on the field and stuff.
It's got to be it. It's got to be Yogg.
Yeah.
Especially since he can have an easy way to pop at 1. Which I can. Yeah, there it is. I feel like we've seen like 6 Yoggs today already. It's been ridiculous. The last series, both players had like 4 Yoggs. It's not even possible in a best of 5, but. All right, here we go.
Here we go. Ooh, boss. That's not a good start. At least gets to draw a card, though.
Polymorph 4. Twisting Nether.
Wow. Okay, let's see what the rest of the cards are. Oh,
oh
does he heal himself?
Heal himself.
Oh,
yeah,
very
back
nice.
To 17. Okay, back to 16. I mean, he's still got a lot of spells left. Like,
yeah, oh, I mean.
I think he cast.
Oh!
Oh. Wait, what? 2 Wobbling Runs in 1 game?
Yeah, that's.
What are the odds?
It's double I've ever seen in my whole life, so.
I think most Hearthstone players have seen more Wobbling Runs in this match than they've seen in their entire Hearthstone careers.
Yep. Excellent, excellent Yogg.
That's insane. Top notch. Deal, clear the board. Heal for
probably
11, I think. Because he's at 20 now, and he was at 9. So he healed for 11, cleared the board. Drew 2 cards.
3.
Got... Well, drew 2 cards.
Oh, yeah, right.
Got No. Actually, drew 1 card and got 2 cards that weren't in his deck in the first place.
Yeah.
One of those being a 0 mana spell that draws a card, which is fantastic for Flame Waker. So Flame Waker plus Firelands Portal plus excess mana. Should be able to clear off at least one of these 2/2s.
Highly probable. Ooh, Tusk Guard Jouster.
If he gets both, Sniper Flame Waker. Nope. Ooh. Okay.
Okay.
Oh my gosh. This is our life now.
This is Jackpot's life now.
Silver Moon Portal is not what you want, though, on that Flame Waker.
Oh, but
somebody, he has mana, so probably casted an Innervate. Secrets are exactly what you want, though. I didn't even see the secrets. What were the secrets?
You got one ice block. No, ice barrier, sorry.
Ice barrier, okay.
I didn't quite see what the first one was.
This could be bad.
Ooh.
Yep.
Oh, no. That's pretty nice. Gets to draw some cards.
Draw a card, backstab.
Well, Mastiff.
His Arcane Giant isn't green. So that means he discarded?
Oh, that would be really
bad. Because it's zero mana. Yeah, he had to have discarded, right?
Probably.
No, but his Innervate's green. I don't even know. Huh? Maybe he casts a Soulfire?
Oh, that would be... Oh, no.
Yeah, dark bargain. I don't know. I think that's okay.
Yeah. But I mean...
And you get two damage in. And his hero powers now deal two damage.
The Arcane Giant is pretty big, though. He's seen his opponent use a lot of his spells.
Yeah. Okay, well now Jackpot has zero spells left.
Yeah.
And so Ice Barrier is one of those, and the second one was, what was it?
Didn't quite see it, sorry.
Yeah, me neither. Sorry.
Sorry, viewers.
Oh, apparently it's Repentance. Not that big of a deal.
No.
Take your medicine.
Well, this game got out of control very quickly.
A lot of cards you normally wouldn't see get played by these decks.
Yeah.
Really throws a wrench into works.
Ooh, oh, wow.
So that's, what, 10 damage?
You can pop the block.
Yeah.
So I think you just have to go for it. You pop the block, and you can also set him at, so this will deal 6, so bring him to 5. You set him at 1 as well, so Shy has to kill him this turn. I just don't think it's possible. He got there.
Yeah.
Somehow. Some way. He's done it. Jackpot needs a very good card. Bear Image is not going to do it.
No, there's literally no way now.
Yeah. So,
well, I mean, he's going to draw.
I don't even know what he can draw.
Yeah,
Babbling Book into second ice block. Cabal's Tome into ice block.
Mm.
But that's going to be Shy taking game number one, winning the Yogg battle.
Yeah, that MVP run, Rambling Runs.
That thing got in probably 12
points
damage.
Least 9.
It hit for 2 once, and then it got buffed up to 3 and hit like 4 more times. So, crazy little guys.
Yeah.
Wily, Grumbly, and...
The
third one that everybody always forgets.
it's only that third one.
Don't remember his name.
First two everyone always remembers, but...
Yeah. But yeah, moving into game number two. Now, Shy has his Token Druid out of the way, so he's got a sort of hybrid midrange hunter remaining, mm-hmm. and a questing adventure rogue, pretty standard questing adventure list.
Mm-hmm.
So I definitely like rogue, but I'm not sure how it matches up against the other two decks. Hunter does really well against it. Token Druid usually does pretty well against it.
Yeah.
And Temple Mage is pretty close. But Rogue, I think, is slightly favored in the Temple Mage matchup because they lack hard removal. It depends who gets ahead early. But Rogue actually has a lot of poor matchups. Rogue's win rate across the board is actually quite low outside of like the highest level of tournament play where you see Masters play it a lot or like one-trick ponies.
Yeah.
But Temple Mage is sort of in the same boat where Temple Mage's win rate across the board is very low. Like, Temple Mage's win rate in tournaments is below 50%. Win rate on ladder, you know, across thousands and thousands of games is below 50%.
Mm-hmm.
But it's there because it counters some very tough matchups. So
it can also be super hit or miss, you know, if you don't get those one mana spells or you don't get those Flame Wakers on time.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah, you really want that Flame Waker around, you know, turn 4, 5, 6. And if you don't, it's kind of like,
Yeah, and it's the same with Rogue. Rogue is sort of in a similar boat where a lot of times it's really inconsistent. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you look at the most powerful decks right now, there's ones that curb out Dragon War is consistent because it's got a consistent early curve. All shamans are consistent because they have some of the best early drops in the game and the best minions to curve out within the game.
Yeah.
Even Hunter now is becoming strong because it got more tools in the early game, like Kindly Grandmother, to get it through. And also people are just building it better by putting more one drops in the deck to make their curve better. So. Begin.
It's going to be that hybrid Hunter here coming out.
He's got the coin, and he threw away Barnes. Barnes can win you games with Midrange Hunter.
Yeah.
If you get a high main or even like an infested wolf from Barnes, sometimes you can just win. You can just snowball the game from there and win. I understand where Shai's coming from and that he doesn't want his hand clogged up with 4-mana minions. But his early curve actually with this deck isn't that good. He's got a sort of a bloated early game, mid game, with he runs 2 Deadly Shots and 1 Stranglethorn Tagger. And he only runs, I believe, 2 one drops, or 4 one drops with Fiery Bat, and only 4 two drops as well, which is below average for Hunters. So I understand where he's coming from, and then he wants to try and hard mulligan for early game minions. But I think keeping Barnes is probably worth it.
Probably won't. Maybe it felt like a little bit of a low chance that he would have gotten the correct, you know, death rattle minion to win the game. Because otherwise, like,
I mean, it's still 4 or 5 worth of stats, and even the quote unquote bad minions to get out of Barnes in Hunter are actually pretty good. Like, even if you get Fiery Bat or Huge Toad,
yeah, that's good.
Or Kindly Grandmother. The only bad ones are like Houndmaster and Abusive Sergeant. Okay. Those are really the only like really bad ones because they're just vanilla 1/1s. I guess Stranglethorn Tiger, but even Stranglethorn Tiger would have Stealth.
Right.
So, I mean, that adds an extra little element to the whole debacle.
Great start for Jackpot, but next few turns might be a little awkward here.
He might be able to just race.
Yeah, just go Fireball Face here.
Yeah, Fireball Face. I mean, this is the only time it's going to cost 3 mana and also deal 7 damage probably for the rest of the game because of Sorcerer's Apprentice Mana Worm. So you Fireball this turn, you push 7 plus 6, you push 13 damage, put your opponent at 12. You already have Firelands Portal in your hand, which means that's an extra 5, so you only have to piece together 7 more damage over the course of the rest of the game. And that's given your opponent clears your board the next turn, which is very unlikely on turn 4 for him to be able to do that. Even if he draws Unleash the Hounds, he still only clears 1 minion.
Right.
He'd have to draw Unleash the Hounds plus exactly Abusive Sergeant in order to do that. So he's going to hit with one of these minions again, most likely. Actually, 100% he's going to hit with one of these minions.
Ooh. Pretty big gamble there, but having seen your opponent go all in like that, you probably have to take some risks here.
Yeah, and if he draws any damage...
Oh. It's not the ideal form of damage.
1 damage to face.
Yeah.
Now he effectively wins. He pings next turn, and then he Firelands Portals on turn 7, and...
Damn.
Jackpot should just take this game. I don't see any way that Shai is going to be able to kill him in 2 turns.
Jackpot kind of barely looking at the screen. He's
like, yeah, this game's over.
I got this.
So I wonder what the admins would do if I just napped.
Just wrote a little macro script to play it out for him.
Yeah. He's like, yeah, I might as well just play this Flame Waker. Who cares?
Yeah, he's actually just, I won. I got this.
Be the coolest thing I could get off Firelands Portal and I win the game.
Oh, here we go. What do you think of, slight BM in tournaments, try and throw your opponent's mental state off? Do you think it's effective at all?
It shouldn't be effective.
Right.
Most players should just be able to ignore it. You know, if you really care about min-maxing, just squelch your opponent at the beginning of the game and never emote. A lot of players do that just because they don't want to even have it come close to affecting them. But it's in the game, so I don't really say it's good or bad. Some people do it, some people don't. But I guess intentionally roping is bad, but not many players would go to that extent. So Jackpot takes game two, and that was a quick win.
Just yeah.
Right on turn seven, ended the game.
I think, though, in esports, like, kind of playing mind games before matches is kind of something that people don't really think about or try to do much. Like, in sports or UFC and stuff, you know, there's a lot of trash talk before and try to throw your opponent's mental game off.
Yeah.
That could be pretty cool because I think, you know, a lot of these pro gamers, they play a lot of games but might not have very much experience just full-on person-to-person trash talk on a stage or something.
I thought you were going to say very much experience with social interaction.
I didn't want to go that way. But
didn't want to go that far?
No.
Yeah. Yeah. I feel like Hearthstone is a game where you, like, friendly trash talk is probably welcome.
Yeah.
Because it builds storylines for players.
Mm.
If you want to build a name for yourself in Hearthstone, the best way to do it is just to BM somebody.
Yeah, just embrace the villain. Just, like, you know, in WWE, just be the villain.
Yeah.
Just take the public hate, but at the same time, people will still watch you.
They're as long as it's not excessive. Like, friendly trash talk. Of course. You gotta make that clear.
Mm-hmm.
Famous America's player, Chalky, made a name for himself a long time ago by BMing and in some big-scale tournaments. And then for a long time, he never BMed. He was always super polite and always like sportsmanlike, but people still will say, oh, Chalky, you know, the guy that BMs a lot.
Oh, right.
Even though he hasn't in, like, years.
Mm-hmm.
People still think that. And so, you know, it can sometimes be a good way to build a name for yourself, but it can also just follow you.
Right.
Forever, even when you don't want it to.
Yeah. I mean, also, if you talk a lot of trash and then you lose, it looks super bad.
Yeah, it does. All right, well, one cool thing about Jackpot is that all of his decks are full golden. All four of them.
Wow.
Well, actually, I haven't known for sure if this is what it is, but we'll see when the coin comes into his hand. Yep, full golden. All four decks.
Wow. It's very impressive for someone who only recently got the game, apparently.
Yeah.
I mean, he's pumped a lot of money into it.
Yeah. Said he's an engineer, so usually
good at numbers,
pretty good money. So
yeah, that's true.
He can afford to pay for Hearthstone for the rest of us.
Double conceal already in hand. Preparations though is nice though. You can get those nice combos.
Conceal is actually really important in this matchup, I think, though.
Mm-hmm.
Because one of the ways you win is just by racing.
Oh, yeah.
And that means getting an early Van Cleef or an early Questing Adventure. You basically have to take big risks. This is usually a pretty bad matchup for the Rogue. It didn't used to be, because mid-range Hunters used to be a lot slower.
Yeah.
And but people, one, mid-range Hunters learned how to play it by, like, not slamming high main on six if you had a decent plan, because it's vulnerable to sap, and, you know, just like hitting face a lot and hero powering a lot was a way to win this, because rogues just don't have a way to heal. So now I think it's pretty hunter favored.
Well, maybe we'll see a comeback of the Earthring Farseers.
Well, Questing Adventure. Prep, Eviscerate, Conceal. And then next turn he can roll into Tomb Pillager Conceal if he really wants to try and get the damage rolling heavily onto this Questing Adventure and protect it. Jackpot does run one Deadly Shot. So okay, that's the only risk here, but like I said, you have to take risks.
Pretty weird turn four as well, considering you can't really use the Quick Shot now.
I guess he just huge toads. That seems really weak.
Yeah.
But probably the only play available to him.
And Houndmaster naked without the synergies. Very suboptimal.
Yeah, nobody wants to see a naked Houndmaster. Which I don't think Dushai's next turn, if it's better to Azure Drake or Tomb Pillager and Conceal. Azure Drake leaves your. Unless you pick up Backstab and can use it, or Prep, it leaves your Questing Adventure at 6, and it means you probably wouldn't be killing anything on the board, because you'd want to push that 6 damage in face, so it'd be vulnerable to whatever Jackpot has.
It is pretty difficult to throw something with 6 health die against a Hunter.
Yeah.
You know, you're definitely going to need 2 cards at least pump that damage out.
Yeah.
Get in there and fight, maggot!
Okay. Zap's not good right now, but it's going to be really good.
Yeah, for the Savannah High mains, it's one of the best feelings.
Yeah, two pillager conceal might be better here. Just because this board is really awkward to deal with at the moment. He'd push six. He'd push six damage this turn, and he would have 12 damage on board for the next turn. So, jackpot.
12.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's gonna do that because, like you said, you know, you do have to race a lot of the time here, and
yep, gotta take those risks. And he has sap, so if Shy bests a lot of the board into basically anything big,
or
he can
taunt.
Just sap it or taunt. Yeah.
Shy himself is getting a little low here.
I think he can save that coin. If you want to kill him next turn, you could still kill command, quick shot, coin hero power if you need to. Maybe he's thinking if he wants to high main next turn, he wants to damage in right now. Yeah. Backstab.
Really saving.
Oh wow, he can trick. Okay. Actually, the Tomb Pillager plus trade was really interesting.
Oh, because you can coin. Yeah.
You can coin out. You can like Azure Drake backstab and then coin out a sap or something like that, or coin out a dagger. I mean, I guess this play works too. Because you're still investing a lot into this questing adventure, and now all of a sudden you basically just hit him twice and he's gonna win the game. So I don't know, this should be game unless Jackpot picks up a deadly shot and can pick this off, but yeah, there's no way for him to live. No, well, there's a way for him to live in maybe, like if he huge toads and then kill commands the Azure Drake, but literally Shy has to play a card, has to have a playable card, and every single card in his deck would be playable.
Yeah, just
there would be no card that would be no card that wouldn't be playable. Even backstab would be playable because he'd be able to use it on his questing adventure.
Right. He's just hoping now.
Yeah. Ooh, I hope you, that card in your hand gets discarded and you don't draw another one.
Thank you.
And there it is. Cold blood for the finish.
A little bit of overkill as well.
Mm-hmm.
Saying this is how much damage I had.
Yeah, I mean, if your opponent's going to play it out, you might as well play it out as well like that.
All right, so Shy takes another win in the series with the Rogue, and now just his Hunter deck remaining to find a win with. So Jackpot has Token Druid and his own Hunter left. So he's got a mirror matchup plus a matchup that's actually not too great for the Druid.
Mm-hmm.
So not a good situation for Jackpot going into game number four. He's got an uphill battle for sure if he's going to want to try and make it through to the winner's bracket finals. The winner of this match goes to the winner's bracket finals, so they guarantee at least third place.
Do you think either of these Hunter decks have an advantage in the mirror, just looking at the lineup?
I think the faster Hunter always wins,
okay.
Which would be Shy's in that case, mm-hmm. Because Jackpot's is sort of a classic mid-range Hunter. He's got double Elec and double Stranglethorn Tiger.
Yeah.
So he's got a lot of the top end. The double 5-drop is something that most players don't go with. Mm-hmm. Actually, most players don't even run 5-drops anymore in Hunter.
Yeah.
They've cut them all out. So having the faster deck usually means that you're going to win. So Shy is a hybrid Hunter, though. He does have one Stranglethorn, and he does have two deadly. So his mid-range is a lot more packed. So I don't know. It's tough to say, but I'm pretty sure Shy's was faster.
Okay. So you probably go with the Druid, right? As Jack.
Yeah, it doesn't matter, though. Mm. He's got to win with both.
Yeah, it just comes back to that random number generator.
Just comes back to the, yeah. I mean, a lot of it depends on the player. Some players like to put their best match out there first.
Yep.
If I was in his situation, I'd probably pick Hunter because I want to get the mirror match by the way first. But really, it doesn't matter.
Okay,
does not matter.
So actually, I want to go back to that question that I had.
Okay.
Nope, never mind. Sorry.
Wait, you never even told the story from earlier.
No, I didn't.
Twice. The question, story sauce question.
Yeah.
Well, hopefully this game goes in Jackpot's favor because I really want to hear that. And if Shy wins, we're still going to hear it. So write it down so you don't forget. Thank you.
I'll draw a star little, on my...
Yeah.
And it'll remind me of story.
Okay. Oh, you actually circled the star too. Okay.
No, it's a pentagram. Oh, crap.
Well, Shy has a pretty awful hand early on. He's got a one drop, but it's the worst one drop. And he's got three drops, but they're all the worst three drops. And draws into a Stranglethorn Tiger. So Hero Power Pass. I talked about how Shy's mid-range, the mid-game of his deck, is very clogged. And this is one of those situations that you don't want to find yourself in. It's one of the reasons why Hunter players are putting a lot of one drops in their deck and cutting some of their three drops, whether they run one bow or one kill command. If you run the secret version, I think it's better to run one kill command because you have bow synergy. If you're running a non-secret version, I think it's better to run one bow because... Mm-hmm. Bow is just not as good. It draws a Houndmaster.
Yes. I mean, that's usually a pretty awesome 4-drop on turn 4, but don't have anything on the board.
Maybe Jackpot will summon a beast for him. Is there any card that would do that? Hunger Dragon. Could summon a Stone Tusk Boar. And then you'd have to not trade into it. Or Hunger Crab.
Right.
Hunger Crab would be better. 2 health.
Yeah. A little beefier.
Okay.
Do you go for a spell?
Yeah. I'm just waiting for somebody to go for a minion.
Yeah. I mean, there's just, like you said last time, just way more good spells than there are good minions.
Shy, though, made it through the early game
unscathed.
Well, took 6 damage, but effectively unscathed, and that is a Skeleton Knight. Skeleton Knight, one of the weirdest joust cards.
Yeah.
When it dies, it jousts, and if it wins, then it goes back into your hand. All right, well, Skeleton Knight's gone forever.
Well, he has another chance to come back through the second Moonglade Portal.
Second Moonglade Portal and the second Skeleton Knight? Then it's really going to win the joust.
Right.
Yeah. It's got to be Ancient of War. Most likely. I mean, he can swipe and remove, but he's not really removing everything. Actually, maybe it's better to play the long game. Shy's running out of resources, but then again, you probably want to start with the Ancient and then follow up with the spells to support it. Chances are he won't be able to deal with this unless he's got spells from hand, so you can Moonglade it, portal it back up.
I mean, Jackpot just saw Kill Shot. Deadly Shot, sorry.
And Kill Shot.
Yeah.
Been playing too much. Wow.
So I feel pretty comfortable. Be like, yeah, well, what are the chances he has a second one in the hand right now?
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. Shy does run double Deadly Shot. Sort of bizarre. But now Jackpot has a much cleaner clear on this board with Swipe Wrath for 1 plus Hero Power. Does leave him with a completely empty board for Call of the Wild, though, and no spells in his hand. But in that case, he'd have Innervate Yogg.
True. Not that many spells have been played, though, is it?
There's been quite a few. He's played Living Roots, he's played Wild Growth, he's played Raven Idol, he's played...
Moonglade Portal.
One Moonglade Portal.
I think it's... The magic number is 6 or more, right? 6 or more spells, and then... I think someone made a chart, and I saw it was like 6 or more spells, and if your opponent has minions on the field, it's... There's a 51.8% chance that you clear the board.
Wow.
I read.
I would, that doesn't seem like a very fun way to spend like a weekend. I'm going to calculate the exact odds that Yogg-Saron will do something very specific. Yeah. Oh, Call of the Wild!
Ah, perfect draw there. And Piggy gets to go face. Oh. Or do you actually clear the Blood Mage? Fear Ooh. Of...
Well, Swipe would do almost exactly the same.
Sure.
Whether or not
Blood yeah, Mage... Yeah, right.
So, the only thing is, like, Wrath would kill the Huffer.
Mm-hmm.
But Wrath would kill the Huffer anyway, so I actually don't think the trade is right there.
Okay.
I don't really like the trade. That's 5 damage that you're pushing. Because Wrath would kill the Huffer anyway. Swipe would kill the Huffer anyway.
So maybe he didn't want Wrath to kill Leok.
Scaled? What is that? Scaled? Drake? It doubles its attack every turn?
Yeah. Is it Scaled Drake? Or is it... Yeah, it is.
Scaled Nightmare.
I was going to say Nightmare Drake for a second there. But Nightmare seems to be in my head for some reason.
Well, yeah. It's met a very quick end.
Yeah.
And Shy just continuing to push damage. But Jackpot's got like a 7, 8? Somewhere between 7 and 10 spell Yogg. Wait, what? Arcane Giant is 6? So it's an 8 or 6 spell Yogg? Is it 6? Is it 6 mana?
So looks six like spell it Yogg. Could be. That's one, that's two.
Three. Well, if Flame Lance hits one of the opposing minions, that's not good. Mark the Wild on one of his own minions. That's not good.
It's a cruel Yogg.
Naturalize on his opponent's minion. There it is. Ooh. Actually, really I don't even know if that's good.
Yeah, do you really want your hunter to be able to draw 2 cards?
Not quite sure. Forbidden Ritual for nothing and Astral Communion to get rid of the Arcane Giant. Oh, no! That was Yogg's grand finale.
Oh man. I think this is the first Yogg we've seen actually kind of fully backfire.
Well, I don't know. It did clear the board. A lot of the board.
Yeah.
Oh, it's still going.
Okay. Maybe it was 9 spells.
That was more than 9 spells. I couldn't quite see what the Arcane Giant's mana was because it was cut off on the top of our screen, but... So that's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 11 damage currently.
Mirror Image gives him Giant Toad, but that's going to get cleared extremely easily here.
Yeah, and this is sort of cruise control for Shy now. He's in a great spot.
Yeah.
High main plus a Houndmaster in hand.
And you're so comfortable just flood the board now with Yogg out of the way.
So Shy might be on the verge of a victory here. Shy, when we talked to him, said he was the 2014 Hong Kong Regional Champion.
It's a little while ago, but still counts.
There's also no documentation to support it.
Ah, okay. Looks like an honest guy.
Yeah. All right, Arcane Giant is now 0 mana. Maybe it was 0 mana. Maybe he casted 12 spells. Because I could see the bottom of it.
Yeah. It might have been.
Who knows?
Like, it was either 0
now
or 6.
Now it's definitely 0,
six.
Though. Yeah.
So, yeah, it was probably 0.
It was 0.
Yeah.
All right, well... Oh, there's... Even Mulch just isn't very good right now. I mean, he's staring at 9. He's staring at 13 damage. He might just have to Mulch the Leok. Hymen would take away...
One damage.
Leok takes away 2. Sogoth the Slitherer. What? I mean, that's just better, right?
Yeah.
Ah.
That 9 health taunt. That's so hard to get through.
Nah, he's probably gonna just pick up a Call of the Wild here, or at least get closer to a Call of the Wild.
Yeah,
Kill Command puts
third
him...
of a Call of the Wild.
Yeah. Kill Command puts him really close. So Kill Command would mean he'd have 8 damage on board, plus Kill Command would be 13, plus Hero Power would be 15. So he'd be 3 damage off lethal, but Sogoth and just push that 6 damage to the face.
Yeah, Jackpot's head just fell back into his seat there. Exasperation.
Yeah, and unless Jackpot picks up something really crucial from this wild growth, he is dead.
Hmm.
I don't even know what he could pick up. Have to be like Ancient of War. Ancient of War would be actually pretty good. No. I mean, if he clears the Sogoth, there's 6 damage on the board, so he dies to, like, spells. This makes it so that he can't play Ancient of War if he gets it, but he does get 1/1s in the process. So we'll see what he gets. Living Roots. So it turns out this is the right play, but it's not going to be enough. And Shy, you can see a little smirk on his face as he realizes 4 mana. There's nothing you can do at 4 mana that's going to stop me from winning this game. Unless it's Feral Rage for 8 armor.
Yeah.
And so Shy is going to take the series after he takes the game and move on to the winner's bracket finals. Securing himself a top 3 finish.
Yeah. A documented top 3 finish.
Yeah, a documented top 3 finish. There you go. Showed very impressive play. Jackpot, though. I'm sure the home crowd was rooting for him because he is a tie player.
Yeah.
He's not out of the tournament, though.
Nope.
So he'll have to fight through onto the lower bracket. But going down to the lower bracket after you've already made it to the round of 4 winner's bracket is actually not too bad.
Yeah.
You only have to win like 1 extra match or something like that.
Yeah, I think they're 1 round behind, so.
Yeah. But fun series. Got to see a lot of Yogg-Strons. None of them really decided the game completely, but they were all exciting. We got to see 2 wobbling runs as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, so we've got some time now, so I think I'm going to ask you this question / story.
I was about to forget.
Yeah. So on the first night here, me and D2 were kind of talking about this. My question was, do you think talent is like inherently something you're born with? Or is it...
Whoa. This is
slightly philosophical. But because, you know, you have so many, you know, amazing young pro players in the esports, that it makes me wonder, like, or is it just these little things that you pick up as in your upbringing that just kind of happened to culminate into the overall ability to be good at a game or like a sport?
So is there such a thing as a prodigy?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, there's prodigies. I think people's minds work in different ways.
Hmm.
So, you know, there's some people that are good at critical thinking. There's, you know, some people that are just good at like formulas and like mathematics. So, yeah, I mean, it's hard to say because it's almost impossible to know whether it came from like little nuanced decisions that you or your parents made when you were younger that made you pick up on information or whether it was you were born with it. So, I don't know. That's an age-old question, man. Nature and nurture.
Maybe one day with science.
Maybe one day.
We'll be able to figure it out. Just be able to dissect the brain neuron by neuron.
Yeah. Then you get to the point where, like, the scientific studies that you'd have to do would be completely inhumane because you have to, like, lock babies in boxes.
Oh, gosh.
So.
And a lot of them as well.
Yeah, so we don't recommend
that. Sample size.
But, yeah, one thing's for sure, though, is that we have a lot of talented players
at the
Thailand Major here and a lot of talented players in Southeast Asia. Looking forward to seeing the future of the region in competitive Hearthstone and what they can do. And lots of creative decks as well. Mm-hmm. Players aren't afraid to take risks, which is really cool. But we got plenty more Hearthstone to come throughout the rest of the day. Keep in mind, guys, we'll crown a champion for the Thailand Major, so make sure you stay tuned. Before we jump into the next match, we are going to have to go to a quick commercial break. But don't go anywhere, guys. Plenty more Hearthstone action right after this.